Hello everyone, Darryl Johnson, Vital Force Fitness. You know, today I've been wanting to share this with you for some time. It's a recipe today, and it is an alternative to tuna. We call it chickpea of the sea. Now what we're gonna do instead of using tuna, we're gonna use garbanzo beans. It's a very versatile bean. There's so much that you can do with garbanzo beans, or you may have heard garbanzo beans called chickpeas. They're the same thing. Now, for those of you who may not know what garbanzo beans are, have you ever had hummus? Hummus is made out of garbanzo beans, chickpeas. So that's all they are. What we're gonna do now, we're gonna go over to the sink. We're gonna rinse off the can. This is very important. I always stress that. Rinse off your can before you actually open them. And we're gonna actually rinse the beans up under the water, get all the sodium off of it before we mash them up. All right, so what we're gonna do now, we're gonna use two cans of our garbanzo beans. We're gonna rinse them real good. Like I said, get all that additional sodium that's in the can. All right, here we go. Rinse them very good up under there. Now you know those little skins coming off the beans, that's fine. Don't even worry about that. That's a good form of fiber in the body. And I know a lot of you need that fiber. That's one thing about beans, loaded with fiber. Protein, carbs. All right, so what we're gonna do now, we're gonna take this over to our mixing bowl. We're gonna mash them up. All right, so now what we're gonna do is place our garbanzo beans into our bowl. We're gonna mash them up. Now, what I like to use is a potato masher. I tried it inside of a blender. You could do that, but I felt that I didn't get the consistency that I wanted. With a potato masher, I like to leave not whole chunks, but almost like a tuna fish type consistency. If you ever open up a can of tuna fish, you see little chunks in there, so that's what I'm looking for, okay? So what we're gonna do is start mashing up our beans. Okay, so we're done mashing our garbanzo beans. All right, one thing, a little suggestion here that I kind of picked up. There's a time I used to just put my seasoning directly into the garbanzo beans. And one thing I noticed, it did not distribute evenly. So what I'm gonna do now, or what I do now is actually, this is a vegan mayo. Now, if you use regular mayo, you can use regular mayo. This is a vegan mayo. This is actually apple, uses grape seed. The original uses canola oil. You see, I use a lot of it. But today we're gonna use the vegan mayo. Now keep in mind, I've always said this, I eyeball things. A lot of times I like a little bit more moisture to my garbanzo beans. You may like less moisture. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna eyeball this, okay? I'm gonna actually put my mayo into my bowl, a little bit more here. And if I find I need a little bit more, it's easy to add mayo to the mixture once it's mixed up, okay? All right, what we're gonna do now, we're gonna add our seasonings. We're gonna put some onion powder. Once again, I don't measure. It's about a little bit over a teaspoon. I like to add some black pepper in there. Turmeric. Turmeric seems to be the big thing now. It's been around for I don't know how long. A little bit of turmeric. Let's see, some onion powder. I love onion powder. I love onion, period. I love going to Middle Eastern restaurants and get some of that garlic dip. I gotta warn everyone about my breath after eating it though, you know? Now this here is a vegan chicken seasoning. You can find this in a lot of local health food stores. This is something that I grew up using. Instead of using real chicken type seasoning, we would use this. Now, this has like salt and other seasonings in there. It's a great alternative to using chicken seasoning. All right, let's see what else we have over here. Some dry mustard. It gives a little kick to it. You can use regular mustard if you like. It doesn't have to be dry mustard. But for this recipe, I'm all out. You see, I use it a lot. Let's see here. Okay, pickle relish. Now this is not just your ordinary pickle relish. This is special pickle relish. And why it's special? It's vinegar free. Lemon juice is used here instead of vinegar. On a later video, I'm gonna talk about vinegar. I know that vinegar seems to be the crave, but the question is vinegar really healthy for the body? So what we're gonna do, we're going to add some pickle relish to this. We're gonna need a spoon here, so. All right, what we're gonna do is add some of our pickle relish here. Now, I love pickle relish. Personalize this. I've pretty much given you the basic ingredients to use, but personalize it, make it your own taste. If you like more pickle relish, if you like less pickle relish, just add it in there. So we're mixing that up. So we got our sauce. That's pretty much what it's gonna look like, our dressing. Now what we're gonna do is add about 3 stalks of celery. And for time, I've already chopped it up. We're gonna blend this up real quick, okay? What we have here is our celery. This is quite a bit in here, so actually this will work. And next what we're gonna do, we're gonna mix up our onion. Get about a medium-sized onion, more or less. I'm gonna use about a half, this is about a small-sized onion. So what we're gonna do is add the small onion, and we're gonna blend this up. Okay. I like to blend my onion up pretty well though. I'm gonna just move it around in there for a minute. We're gonna blend it up again. Me personally, it's something about biting into a big chunk of onion when it should be blended very well. That's pretty good. And what we're gonna do is add our onions to our chickpeas. Here we go. And we're gonna take our mixture, just kinda like add it in there. It's that simple. You know, I always tell my clients, when I do cooking demonstrations, first of all, you gotta believe that you can cook. A lot of times people have this fear that they cannot cook. It starts with your mindset. And with me, everything actually starts in my head. I kind of visualize it before I actually end up making it. And what I'm gonna do now is just mix it up in here. Make sure it's in there. Mix up very well. Yeah, looking good. You know, some people say that garbanzo beans have a tuna fish type smell to it. Bam! That's our finished product. Chickpea of the sea. This dish here is, I get a lot of calls to actually prepare this for people, for a lot of events that they have. At churches, at businesses, and things like that, and they love it. You know, it's like the big rave. What we're gonna do, ask the cook, of course, about to try, taste it here. Now keep in mind, you can do this on a cracker. You can toast some whole grain, wheat bread or something like that. Get some lettuce and tomatoes and make yourself a sandwich. You can create a vegetable bowl. You have celery, cucumber. Had this sitting in the middle. People just get a little bit, put it on their plate, they're blown away by it. All right, let's do the taste test. All right, let me come back here. But anyway, have confidence that you can prepare this. And I would like to hear your feedback. Let me know what you think. And remember, good health does not happen by chance, but by the lifestyle you make today. Make it a healthy day.
Make sure you choose Rocky Road Productions LLC Porch Talk to feed your entertainment needs. And you can do that by following us on Facebook, Instagram. Make sure you like this video and share it with all your family and friends. Tag somebody in it, why don't you? And don't forget to comment down below and let us know how you feel. And before you leave, make sure you subscribe. That's right. You'll catch us every week. Looking forward to see you again next time. Bye.